Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle, it is 30 and this angle is given 50 degrees and then these two sides are equal and x is s. Okay. First step, notice that we have a 30 degrees, so if you draw perpendicular line opposite of 30 degrees like this, let's call here K point. And if there's a H unit opposite of the 30 degrees, this side, opposite of the 90 degrees must be equal to H, right? Okay. And then if we extend corner D like this, we know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles. That means here must be equal 80 degrees, right? Okay. And then let's create an isosceles triangle. So if we take here 50 degrees, let's call here point T, and we get two isosceles triangle, right? So triangle ADT and triangle TAC is an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, AT must be equal AC. Right? That means here must be equal to H, right? And then if you draw a perpendicular line, we know that the base will be divided into two equal parts because of isosceles triangle. So these two parts must be equal H unit. And then these are 40 degrees, right? Why? Because this line is a bisector line. Next step, these two parts equal, right? So let's call these two equal parts M unit. And let me delete here. Let's call here this point L. So if we apply Pythagorean theorem for triangle ALD, we get the length of the LD, right? So square of LD equal M squared minus H squared, right? According to Pythagorean theorem. Okay, and then for this triangle, let's apply Pythagorean theorem again. Square of KB equal M squared minus H squared, right? That means KB must be equal LD. Therefore, these two sides are equal, right? Okay. And then notice that these two triangles must be congruent, right? So, triangle ALD and triangle CKB are congruent, right? According to side similarity theorem. So, if there is a 40 degrees opposite of the H unit, opposite of the H unit must be equal 40 degrees. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. First step, let's call these equal sides with A. And then this side, I'm going to represent with B. You know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles. That means here angle BDC equal 80 degrees, right? So for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, A or sine 80 must be equal B or sine X. That means A or B must be equal sine 80 or sine X. Okay, this is the first equation. And then for this triangle, let's apply one more sine rule. A or sine 50 must be equal B over sine 30. That means A over B must be equal sine 50 over sine 30. This is the second equation. And then if we equalize first and second equation like this, therefore sine 80 over sine X equal sine 50 over sine 30, right? And then we know that the expansion of sine 80 equal 2 times sine 40 times cosine 40 over sine X, and we can calculate cosine 40 instead of sine 50, right? Over sine 30. And then, if we simplify the expression, these are again, so sine X equal 2 times sine 40 times sine 30. We know that sine 30 equal 1 over 2. So X is going to be 40 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.